Cubs, it's Miss Jessica.
And me, Miss Lily.
Oh, and where is Squirmy? Squirmy has something to show you today. Oh!
Look how well my tomato plant is growing. Can you believe it?
Wow, Squirmy, your tomatoes look so good.
I know, I'm a really good gardener. I have a green thumb. I have lots of green thumbs. Actually, I'm green all over. Maybe that's why I'm such a good gardener.
You are green, Squirmy, but I don't think that's why you're good at growing things.
Look at my tomato. None of my other friends are growing such pretty tomatoes. Wiggly forgot to water his tomato plants, and they all died. Rosebud ate her plants before they even grew tomatoes. And Wooly Bear, he was just lazy and planted his seeds too late in the season. Buckeye said he grew 50 tomatoes this year, but I know he's lying. He only grew 2 little measly tomatoes, and they had brown spots all over them. And Hornworm didn't grow anything at all because his plants got root rot. I am the best tomato grower of all my friends. Maybe in all of Florida, maybe in the United States, or the world.
Squirmy, I think you forgot something very important.
Oh yeah, not only am I the best tomato gardener around, I'm also loving, kind, joyful, peaceful, gentle, and kind.
Oh, Squirmy, you're a lot of those things. But you know what? You have learned a lot from our Sunday school lessons about the fruit of the Spirit. But there's one fruit of the Spirit that is not growing in you.
What is that?
The fruit of the Spirit called goodness.
Goodness? I don't want to let everyone push me around and step all over me. I want to be strong and in control.
Well, goodness isn't about being weak. Goodness is about knowing who you are in Christ. It is knowing that without God you can do nothing. And goodness is knowing that God makes you who you are. This reminds me of a story found in Luke chapter 18. Jesus told this story, and there were two men that went to pray at the temple one day, and the first man was a Pharisee, and a Pharisee is a very important man, and the second man was a tax collector. Well, nobody liked the tax collector, and in this case, the tax collector wasn't very nice normally, and they weren't very honest. They would charge people too much money and then keep some of that money for themselves. Well, the Pharisee stood up to pray and says, "Oh, thank you, Lord. I am not like all these other people. I follow all your rules. I do what I'm supposed to do. I don't cheat like this tax collector over here." But the tax collector got up to pray and prayed a completely different prayer. He prayed, "Dear Lord, please forgive me. I know I'm a sinner. Don't be mad at me." So Jesus asked, who do you think God was happier with, the Pharisee or the tax collector? So, you know, in this case, the Pharisee, he knew all the laws and he followed all the laws, but he didn't see that he was a sinner too. He only saw the sins of other people. The tax collector, without God's help. Goodness is knowing that everything you have and everything you are comes from God. Do you think you could let the fruit of goodness grow in your heart, Squirmy?
Okay, I'll do my best.
Alright, class, let's say bye to Squirmy.
Bye, kids.
We're going to pray. Fold your hands. Father, help us not to be like the Pharisee who thought he was better than everyone else. Help us to know that we have sinned and to be able to admit when we've done something wrong. We know that without your help, we cannot do it. Amen. All right, boys and girls, it's time for our memory verse. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness. Galatians 5:22 and 23. All right, now you do it with me. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness. Galatians 5:22 and 23. All right, boys and girls, it's Miss Jessica.
And me, Miss Lily.
Signing off.
Bye, kids.